कोरोना ने बड़ा ही इम्पेक्ट किया है। तो ये आखिरी अपडेट के साथ में दोस्तों मैं स्वागत करूंगा आज के हमारे जो कीनोट स्पीकर हैं। बड़ा ही अच्छा सब्जेक्ट है, टैक्स ऑडिट अंडर इनकम टैक्स। इस विषय को आगे लेके जाएंगे, जानकार है, एक्सपर्ट है, यूथ है, युवा है, सीए वेदांत पारिक जी का। वेदांत पारिक जी का मैं स्वागत करता हूँ और वेदांत पारिक जी का इस लाइन के साथ में स्वागत करता हूँ कि इत्र से कपड़ों का महकाना कोई बड़ी बात नहीं। इत्र सेंट, इत्र से कपड़ों का महकाना कोई बड़ी बात नहीं। मजा तो तब आए जब आपके किरदार में खुशबू आए। मजा तो तब आए जब आपके किरदार में खुशबू आए। और वेदांत वेदों के ज्ञाता, बाकी इनकम टैक्स के भी ज्ञाता हैं और जीएसटी तमाम मामलों के ज्ञाता हैं वेदांत जी। वेद हमारे चार होते हैं और वेदों का इसलिए जिक्र करता हूँ, कल गणपति बप्पा की का आगमन होगा और महाराष्ट्र में गणेश उत्सव वो दोस्तों इस तरह से मनाया जाता है कि आपके सब दुख तकलीफ सब छोड़ के लोग लग जाते हैं। तो इस गणेश उत्सव की सब लोगों को मैं शुभकामना देता हूँ। साथ ही आप सभी को मैं इस सभी को प्रार्थना करूंगा बप्पा से, इस लाइन के साथ में तमाम आप पार्टिसिपेट, वेदांत जी, विशाल गाला जी, तमाम मेरे जो दोस्त हैं और वेल विशर देख रहे हैं, उन लोगों के लिए जो लाइव देख रहे हैं, उन लोगों के लिए कि धरती पर बारिश की बूंदे बरसे, धरती पर बारिश की बूंदे बरसे, आपके ऊपर अपनों का प्यार बरसे, आपके ऊपर अपनों का प्यार बरसे। गणेश जी बस यही दुआ है, गणेश जी से बस यही दुआ है। आप खुशी के लिए नहीं, खुशी आपके लिए तरसे, खुशी आपके लिए तरसे। और यदि खुशी आप से, इसके लिए आपको बप्पा जो रिद्धि सिद्धि के दाता हैं उनको मनाना होगा। और मैं प्रार्थना करता हूं कि इस गणेश उत्सव के दौरान आप पर बप्पा की कृपा रहे और इस कोरोना काल में विशेष कृपा रहे ताकि हम इस आर्थिक जो हमारे देश की दुनिया की अर्थव्यवस्था है उसको सुधार लाने के लिए बहुत सारे काम करें। मैं दोस्तों एक वो भी रिक्वेस्ट करूंगा तमाम लोगों से, करण नायक जी, करण नायक जी आ चुके हैं। ठीक
जी आ चुके हैं, थोड़ा फोन पे
है
बिजी है वो।
ठीक है ठीक है ठीक है ठीक है। तो वीणा उनकी बिटिया की आवाज आई है। तो दोस्तों मैं गणपति बप्पा का स्वागत करने के लिए, वेलकम करने के लिए मैं कुछ समय के लिए जाऊंगा, तो करण नायक जी संभालेंगे आज की बागडोर, आगे की उसका समापन जो आपका वेबिनार का वो करेंगे। तो वो आपके दोस्त और होस्ट रहेंगे आगे, वेदांत जी, करण नायक जी और वीर एग्रो के बारे में बताएंगे। तो मुझे दीजिए इजाजत, मतलब आज के लिए क्षमा प्रार्थी हूँ क्योंकि गणपति बप्पा हमारे कॉम्प्लेक्स में और मैं ही वहां का पंडित हूँ और उनका आगमन करना है। तो लोगों ने बोला आपका तो चाहिए चाहिए, आपकी वहां पे आगमन लाना है। तो उनको तो वेदांत जी आपका मैं स्वागत करता हूँ और आगे की बागडोर के लिए तो रहेंगे। साथ ही मैं विशाल गाला जी से कहूंगा आज के जो कीनोट स्पीकर है उनके बारे में बताएं अधिक जानकारी और आज के इस वेबिनार की शुरुआत करें। विशाल गाला जी, थैंक यू वेरी मच।
पंडित शर्मा जी, मिलते हैं फिर कभी।
आई वेलकम एवरीवन टू दिस सेशन व्हिच इज ऑन टैक्स ऑडिट अंडर इनकम टैक्स। टू टेक दिस सेशन वी हैव विद अस सीए वेदांत पारिक। सीए वेदांत पारिक इज अ मैनेजिंग पार्टनर ऑफ पारिक एंड एसोसिएट्स। ही हैज एक्सपीरियंस ऑफ मोर देन 5 years इन द फील्ड ऑफ ऑडिट एंड एश्योरेंस एंड ही स्पेशलाइजिंग इन बैंकिंग एंड रियल एस्टेट इंडस्ट्री। हिज एरिया ऑफ एक्सपर्टाइज ऑल्सो इंक्लूड्स फॉरेंसिक ऑडिट एंड कमोडिटी एक्सचेंज रिलेटेड कंप्लायंस। Yes, I've been appointed as an independent professional director of Gujarat City Cooperative Bank Limited and was associated with Mrs. Talati and Company CA Chartered Accountant. He's also pursuing diploma in system audit DISA and valuation degree from ICAI. CA Vedant is also empanel speaker of WIRC of ICAI. Now I request CA Vedant Parekh to take the charge.
Thank you so much, Vishal ji. Good evening to one and all the participants who are attending this webinar. Firstly, at the outset, I would like to congratulate Maharashtra Societies Welfare Association Mahaseva for organizing the webinar for the upliftment and the awareness about the topic to the members of the association. And I would also like to thank Sunil ji for hosting this webinar through their MNS media platform. Apart from that, I hope that each and everyone is safe during this pandemic period, and I hope each and every Mumbaikar is enjoying the rain during this period. As rightly stated by Sunil ji, from tomorrow Ganesh Chaturthi is there, So wishing all of you a happy Ganesh Chaturthi. So starting with today's topic, the topic for today is basics of tax audit. The tax audit, as the name suggests, it is falling under the Income Tax Act. So during this webinar of around 1 hour or 1.5 hour, we'll be discussing about what is tax audit, what are the eligibility criteria which are falling under the tax audit. Then there is a technical term which is known as presumptive taxation. What is presumptive taxation? What are the deadlines or due dates for the submission of the tax audit and the income tax returns? Then if you are talking about tax audit, what is the structure basically? The report and the statement of particulars we'll be discussing in detail. Then the procedure for submission on the part of professional as well as on the part of assessee, how that mechanism works. And at the last, as we all know, whenever there is law for the failure for compliances, there is always a charge for penalty, so that the people on whom the tax law has been made applicable do fall in line with the compliances. So yes, we'll be discussing about the penalties as well. To give the brief about this session, we'll be discussing the basic details about the tax audit, that what tax audit is, what are the criteria, what are the return forms, and etc. But we'll not be taking up the clause by clause details which has been mentioned in the form of 3CD. There are 41 clauses, but I'll be showing some highlights on the topic, that what are the details that is visible in that form 3CD. So starting with what is tax audit. So as I rightly said, as the name suggests, the audit falling under the purview of tax, that is known as tax audit. So it is an examination or review of the accounts of any business or profession carried out by the taxpayers from an income tax viewpoint. Yes, friends, we are talking about the examination or the conduct of audit from the viewpoint of income tax. So where is it mentioned? So it is mentioned under section 44AB of the Income Tax Act 1961, that what are the criteria and what is the compliance norms that is to be followed for the purpose of tax audit. When we are talking about tax audit, as per the law, there two bifurcations has been basically made, one between the business and the second between the profession. So if we talk about the business, we can see various nature of constitutions which is followed or is observed in the economy. Say for example, be it sole proprietorship, be it limited liability partnership, which is an emerging concept for constitution these days. Then there is private limited company, then there is a public limited company or joint venture or any other form of constitution. But when we are talking about profession, be it of any category, but if you're falling under into this industry, then you are falling under the service industry that is related to profession. So that includes engineering, legal, architectural, accountant, medical, technical, or interior decoration. So this can be viewed, this has been categorically defined under the act, but this for simplification, I have made the entire presentation that can be understood in a layman's term. Correct. So moving ahead, when we are talking about the applicability of tax audit, so tax audit, the basic eligibility criteria, we should not pronounce it as eligibility, but the compliance guidelines says that this, if you are falling under this bracket, then you are supposed to carry out the tax audit. Considering the audience as the normal businessman and less of the professional to be involved in the webinar, I have framed the presentation in that manner. So this entire presentation in 1 hour or 1.5 hour will give you detailed brief and basic understanding that what is tax audit, what are the applicability, then the basic frame. So for example, I as a professional has observed many times that the clients or the professionals are basically related into once the work is given to professional, or say for example, to be specific, to chartered accountant, then it has been observed that they provide all the details that has been asked for or called for. And they simply ask that whether my compliances have been made or not. But my dear viewers and the dear participants, it is very crucial and important nowadays to be aware. Say for example, on the 13th of August, when Honorable Narendra Modi ji has introduced the concept of tax charter, taxpayers charter, whereby a trust will be developed, there one of the feature is knowing the actions or the actions or the compliances that have been made by your representative on your behalf with the government authorities. So that is a clear indication to all the businessmen. Apart from that, you being an individual, it is very necessary for you. I totally appreciate and understand that giving appropriate time and devotion to the business is 100% necessary. But giving a certain or required or material time to the compliances as well is also necessary during this period when the government is acting very proactively for the purpose of compliances which are being made by the taxpayers. So my urge is to all the participants that be attentive, or I'm not talking that you should be having detailed or thorough knowledge, but yes, some of the basic knowledge so that you will be in a position to understand what all compliances are going on. And you do not miss in this compliance era any of your compliances which may lead to non-compliance and leading to a payment of higher amount of penalty or interest or charges, if any. So yes, let me jump to eligibility. Now, when we are talking about tax audit, we are here discussing about Section 44AB, where Section 44AB states that any taxpayer or assessee, to be specific in terms of the law, assessee means a businessman or a service provider. So a taxpayer is required to have tax audit carried out if the sales or the turnover or the gross receipts of the business exceeds rupees 5 crore in the financial year. My dear friends, the limit was previously 1 crore to 2 crores. So now that was proposed, and for the assessment year 2021, that means financial year 2019-20, which is going to close this time. So this is the beginning period when majorly all the professionals will be carrying out the tax audit, considering the deadline that we'll be discussing at a later stage. So the now limit has been increased of the turnover to 5 crore rupees. So this is a basic understanding that if my business proceeds, receipts or turnover is exceeding 5 crore, then only I am eligible for tax audit. But there are certain clause and specifications on compliance of which the first condition would be applicable. So here it is stated that the threshold limit of 1 crore for a tax audit is increased to 5 crore with effect from 2021. If the taxpayer's cash receipts are limited to 5% of the gross receipts or turnover, and if the taxpayer's cash payment are limited to 5% of the aggregate payments. Yes, friends, as you all know, government is totally targeting and focusing on digital economy and digital India, whereby they are promoting the digital platform as a medium for carrying out the transaction through a banking platform for each and every business transaction that we are carrying out. So to promote that and to encourage that and to encourage transparency even, and to avoid corruption and use of black money, the government here has stated that the taxpayers' cash receipts are limited to 5% of the gross receipts. On the second end, the payment should be restricted to 5%. So what does this 5% indicate? Let me take an example. Say for example, if your turnover during the year is 5 CR, or say for example 10 CR, 10 crore is your turnover. Out of that, if your cash receipts, if you have made the sale and you have obtained cash, which is limited to say for example 1 crore. So if you see total turnover is 10 crores, your cash receipts is 1 crore, which is 10%. So no, you are supposed to carry out your tax audit, not only because that your turnover is greater than 5 crore, but also because your cash receipts are more than 5%. So let me take an example which will make the concept understand easy. Say for example, your turnover is 1 crore rupees, simple. So what you would say, I'm not eligible for tax audit because my turnover is 1 crore and the limit is 5 CR. But wait, if say for example, 25 lakhs is the cash collection during the year, so that exceeds 5% of the total revenue of 1 CR. So in that case, though your turnover is less than 5 crore, you're supposed to carry out your tax audit considering certain conditions which has been prescribed under the Act and certain presumptive taxation things which we'll be discussing at a later stage. On the other hand, not only the cash receipts, the word mentioned here is and. So, and if the taxpayer's cash payment are limited to 5%. So, on the both the sides, if my cash ledger, so in simple terms, I can say, you have to go to your cash ledger, if the receipts on the receipt side or in the payment side, 5% you have to consider, and you have to map that to gross receipts in case of credits, and debits you have to take in terms of aggregate payments. So if you are complying with these conditions of 5% on the receipt side, 5% on the payment side, then and your turnover is above or less than 5 crore, then you are not falling under the limit of tax audit. Moving ahead, why I am taking the interpretation and understanding of presumptive taxation, which has been prescribed under various sections ranging from 44AD, ADA, AE, BB, BB, A, BBB, because at a later stage, I'll be explaining that not this is not a single condition where tax audit will be applicable. There are certain other specified conditions which you have to read between the lines, making it applicable in other cases where the tax audit is also applicable, apart from the conditions which has been mentioned here is satisfied. Yes, friends, so let's understand what is presumptive taxation. So if I talk about presumptive taxation in terms of section 44AD, so 44AD is with respect to business and 44ADA is with respect to profession. So let us first take the understanding of 44AD. So what does presumptive taxation mean here? So presumptive taxation, as I said, it is covered under section 44AD. Now there has been a turnover criteria which is mentioned there. So any business which has a turnover of less than 2 crore can opt to be taxed presumptively. So now what does this mean? Say for example, I am an assessee, how I can become eligible? The eligibility criteria is fixed to the turnover criteria. So if your turnover is less than 2 CR, then you can opt for this scheme. Now what are the benefits of this scheme? So the condition states that they must declare the profits of 8% for non-digital transactions or 6% for digital transactions. So see here, friends, also government is promoting digital transaction whereby they have given a gap of 2% in case of profit. So whichever one is applicable. There are certain exceptions to it. Life insurance agents, commission of any kind, or running of business of plying, hiring, leasing of goods carriage are not covered under presumptive taxation. Apart from this category, any of the assessee carrying out the business can take the benefit of presumptive taxation if a turnover is up to 2 crore. So, why would I go under 44AD? What is the difference between 44AD and 44AB that we'll be covering at a later stage with an example, so that it will be easy for you to understand which scheme to be opted for? Yes, let's take an example to understand 44AD. Correct. So, ABC is an enterprise which has gross receipts of 1.5 CR for financial year 17-18, say for example, and they do not maintain books of accounts. ABC have opted for presumptive taxation. During the year, ABC enterprise received 70 lakh through non-digital transaction, that is cash payments, and 80 lakh through digital transaction. So what will be the income under the head business and profession if I'm falling under 44AD? So here the calculation will go like digital transaction, the amount was 70 lakh. So for non-digital, it is 8% of the revenue. So you have to show minimum profit of 5,60,000. For digital transaction, there is benefit of 6%. So it goes to 4,80,000. So your income directly under PGBP will be 10,40,000. And you will be supposed to tax at this amount. So what is the difference between 44AD and 44AB? So 44AB will go more on the amount part of the business there, whereby the profit margin may vary depending on the nature of business or profession. But if you're falling under AD, then you have to specifically fixed amount of profit has to be shown, 8% or 6%. Now, many of the businessmen will say that our profit in actual this day, this day, for example, 1% or 2%. So why will I go under 44AD? So I'll give you a best solution or best idea why many of the people go for 44AD. So here are the benefits for presumptive scheme. So in presumptive scheme taxation, your net income is considered as 8% of your turnover and you have to pay tax on that income straight away. No calculation, no making of balance sheet P&L. You'd simply identify your total turnover, apply 8% or 6% as ever, whatever the case may be. Directly on that total, apply the tax rate and that will be your taxable amount. Correct. If your receipts are in digital form, it will be 6%, but obvious as discussed. You don't have to maintain accounting records. Yes. So if I talk about 2 crore turnover here, we are talking about all those assessees or taxpayers who are not large in scale or not carrying out the business at a very large platform. So the limit as such is 2 crore. So it is covering the small business and small enterprises. So as to give them the benefit The government has came up with a comprehensive scheme known as presumptive scheme, whereby a fixed income tax has to be paid by those assessees, whereby they do not have to maintain any books of account. So that is a great relief to the small and business retail shop people who do not want to maintain records but simply want to pay the tax. So this is a good suggestion for all these people who are in the small category. You don't have to get your accounts records audited. So this is another benefit. No accounting records, no audit, simple. You have to pay advance tax, but instead of estimating income and paying tax on quarterly basis, you have to simply pay at the year end. So this is also a simple mechanism. So for all those who have doubt why to go for presumptive scheme, so these all are the benefits. Consider these benefits and utilize presumptive scheme. But before going to presumptive scheme, there are certain criteria which you should go through. So for example, if you're going under presumptive scheme for remaining for coming 5 years, you can't shift from presumptive to normal taxation. So there are certain conditions which you must go through before going to presumptive scheme directly. Now, if I'm talking about profession, we have discussed about the limit of 2 CR, which is for business. Now, if you are carrying out profession, which we discussed earlier, lawyer, architect, chartered accountant, etc. So in that case, the limit is 50 lakh. As in the previous 44 AD, it was 8% and 6%. In the profession case, as the expenditure are not more in nature, the criteria here given is straight away 50%. Say, for example, if my receipts from the profession is 50 lakh, then simply I have to apply 50%, which is 25 lakh. And on that 25 lakh, I have to pay the tax. So that is my taxable amount. Correct. So this is the difference between profession and business. Further, in the similar line, not bound to maintain any books of accounts too. Further, you'll be liable for tax audit in scenario where he offers income lesser than the income arrived on presumptive basis, and also his income exceeds the basic exemption limit. So what does this mean? It will come in the later stage, but let me explain you right now because we are going in a good understanding mode of the 44 ADA. So let me read it again for you. He'll be liable to pay tax. He will be liable for tax audit if he offers income lesser than income arrived at on presumptive basis. Say, for example, 50 lakh is 1 crore is my, say, let's say, for example, 2 CR. 2 CR is my, no, let me take 50 lakh only. Say, for example, 50 lakh is my revenue from profession. I have to apply 50%, so that comes to 25 lakhs, right? So, say, for example, I do not want to show my taxable income at 25 lakh, rather I go for 20 lakhs, correct? So, for example, if I go for 20 lakhs, then I am not fulfilling the condition of showing 50% as per ADA. Then in that case, I have to get my accounts audited as per 44AB. So that is what the condition which has been mentioned here. The second condition is also his income exceeds the basic exemption limit, which is 2,50,000 in case of individual. Now, there are certain professions which we discussed earlier, but there may be other professions carrying out non-specified professions which has not been mentioned. So if you are carrying out any profession other than those disclosed as discussed earlier, you would need to maintain such books of accounts so as to enable an assessing officer to calculate your taxable income as per income tax law. However, this mandate would arise only if your income and if you are an individual exceeds 2.5 lakhs, that is the basic exemption limit that we discussed, or gross receipts are more than 50 lakhs. So it is in this similar period in any of the immediately three preceding years. So what does this mean? This means that it is in the similar line, be it other profession mentioned or the profession not mentioned. If your turnover exceeds 50 lakh in the previous year, then for the current year, your tax audit would be applicable. So let us understand with the help of an example. Mr. X is a practicing doctor and he has an actual income of 50 lakh. Now, this example will help you to understand whether you should go for presumptive or you should go for normal taxation. Let us understand. So the actual expenditure incurred by Mr. Rakesh doctor was only rupees 5 lakh out of 50 lakh. So first case I'm talking about with presumptive taxation. So thereby we are charging 50 lakh as an income against which we are considering as it is presumptive as per section 44 ADA. You have to straight away apply 50% of that income. So that comes to 25 lakh. So net taxable income will be 50 lakh minus 25 lakh. That comes to 25 lakh. On that taxable income, you are supposed to pay the tax. On the other side, if you are not following the preemptive taxation, then your income is 50 lakh. Your actual expenditure is 5 lakh because you are not falling under ADA, you are following normal regime. Then your taxable income will be 45 lakh rupees. Now you have to decide, you have to evaluate which option is beneficial for you. Correct? So here taxable income, if I'm going for presumptive, it is 25 lakh. If I'm not going out, I'm paying tax on 45 lakhs. But there are certain pros and cons. Because, for example, deductions and other expenditure will be allowed there. Here in presumptive taxes, it will not be allowable. So this is for the just clarity purpose to understand that there is a concept of presumptive taxation. I hope that would have been clear. Now, as we have discussed about business and profession under 44AD and ADA, there are other four sections as well, which is 44AE, 44BB, 44BBA and BBB. So that talks about business of flying, hiring and leasing goods, carriage, business of exploration, business of aircraft, and these are exceptional nature. Business of civil construction, etc. in turnkey power projects. Now, let's talk about the applicability. Not that 5 crore condition in case of business and 50 lakh in case of profession condition. Yeah, I forgot to mention, say for example, under 44AB, for the business category, the limit has been increased to 5 crore. But if I talk about profession, it has been restricted to 50 lakh, as we have seen in the example. So apart from that condition, even what are the other exception cases where the tax audit though will be applicable not following those conditions? So for business, let's understand case one, where I'm carrying on a business, not opting for presumptive taxation scheme. So in that case, as we have discussed, if your total sales, turnover, gross receipts exceed 5 crore in the financial year, then it will be applicable. I have put a strict considering that 5% of cash payment and cash receipts condition. So that is as simple as to understand. Now going to second case, carrying on business eligible for presumptive taxation under section 44AE, BB, BBB. So this was the purpose why I have taken that in the previous slide. So you are carrying on that business. So what is mentioned here, claims profit or gains lower than the prescribed limit under presumptive taxation scheme. So to make you understand this, let me take third example on the second part. So carrying on business eligible for presumptive taxation under section 44AD. So here it means that if an assessee declares taxable income, which is below the limits prescribed under presumptive tax scheme. And what is that under AD? 2 crore. Yes. And as income exceeding the basic threshold limit. So the condition there was 8% or 6% as the case may be. But I am an assessee who is saying that my actual profit is only 2%. And if I go for presumptive taxation, I am paying higher tax. I do not want to pay higher tax. I want to follow simple mechanism whereby my basic exemption limit is higher. My profit or taxable income is higher than the basic exemption limit. Then I am falling under the presumptive tax. Then I am falling under the tax audit under 44AB. Let me make it more clear. Carrying on business eligible for presumptive taxation under 44AD. I am an assessee who is going under 44AD. Maine aisa bola ki meri income aise hai, mujhe books of account maintain nahi karni. Straight away 8% or 6% mujhe tax bhar dena hai. Theek hai. Okay, to bhar do. But maine aisa dekha considering this current scenario, say for example of COVID or poor business conditions, my actual receipts or actual profit is 1-2%. So a layman, will he go for 6% and 8% and paying tax on that amount? No, in that case, they will not go. So what is the remedy available to them? Yes, there is a remedy available under the Act. Aap aisa kariye ki aap aapke accounts 44AB ke andar audit karwaiye instead of AD and then file your return. So aapke paas ye option rahega ki maan lo ki aapke condition fulfill ho gayi hai, AD ki condition fulfill nahi karni, but mujhe ITR to bharna hai. और मुझे उतनी हायर अमाउंट पे टैक्स नहीं भरना, तो यस देयर इज अ रेमेडी अवेलेबल, यू कैन गो फॉर सेक्शन 44AB इन दिस कंडीशन. सिमिलरली फॉर 44AE, BBB, BBB, उनमें भी ऐसी कंडीशन दी गई है 8%, 6% और 20-50% जैसी. अगर वो आप फुलफिल नहीं करते तो आपको 44AB बाय डिफॉल्ट लग जाएगा. लास्ट इज कैरिंग ऑन बिजनेस विच इज डिक्लेयरिंग प्रॉफिट एज पर प्रिजेंटिव टैक्सेशन स्कीम अंडर 44AD. If the total sales turnover or gross receipts does not exceed 2 crore in the financial year, then the tax audit will not apply. Ye to aapko basic understanding aa hi jani chahiye, correct? Now let's go ahead. ये हमने बात की बिजनेस की, नाउ लेट्स टॉक अबाउट प्रोफेशन। प्रोफेशन में ऐसा है कि जो मैंने बताया कि लिमिट 50 लाख, अगर वो 50 लाख की लिमिट के अंदर आप हो तो आपको टैक्स ऑडिट नहीं करवाना, बट इफ यू आर क्रॉसिंग दैट लिमिट यू आर एलिजिबल फॉर टैक्स ऑडिट। यहाँ पे भी कैरिंग ऑन प्रोफेशन एलिजिबल, बेनिफिट क्या क्या रहेगा और कंडीशन क्या है कि ही क्लेम्स प्रॉफिट और गेन लोअर देन द प्रिस्क्राइब्ड अंडर द प्रिजम्प्टिव टैक्सेशन स्कीम। जैसे प्रीवियसली हमने डिस्कस किया कि आप प्रिजम्प्टिव में तो हो बट आपको वो टैक्स अमाउंट नहीं भरनी, तो आपके पास दूसरी कोई राह है, यस देयर इज एन ऑप्शन, यू कैन लीव द हाउस ऑफ 44AD, 44AB हाउस विल इज रेडी टू वेलकम यू विद अ लोअर परसेंटेज ऑफ द टैक्सेशन। करेक्ट, इनकम एक्सीड्स द मैक्सिमम अमाउंट नॉट चार्जेबल टू टैक्स, दैट इज बाय डिफॉल्ट। Let's go ahead. Business loss. Yes, this is the third category. यहाँ पे हम discuss करेंगे इनसे। For example, it is a huge lucrative area. Many people have this doubt. Say for example, there is a company who is incurring losses on regular basis. So say for example, on previous 3 years they were filing 44AB. Now current year they are facing a business loss. So whether they are required to get their accounts audited? So answer to that is, if your total sales exceeds rupees 5 crore, then yes, even though it is loss and you are not opting for presumptive taxation scheme, then it is mandatory for you to go for tax audit. Second case, if taxpayer's total income exceeds the basic threshold limit, which is 2,50,000, and he has incurred a loss from carrying on a business, not opting for presumptive taxation. Presumptive taxation is which section? 44AD, ADA, etc., etc. So in case of loss from business where sales or turnover which has exceeded 5 crore, the taxpayer is subject to tax audit. So this is an in the continuation only, the question has been reframed in a different manner. The third question, I am an associate who is carrying on the business and I am opting for presumptive taxation under section 44AD and I am having a business loss but with income below threshold limit, will the tax audit be applicable? We are time and again discussing threshold limit. As your threshold limit is not there and not crossing, the tax audit will not be applicable. Third case, carrying on business and having business loss, but with income exceeding basic threshold limits, then declares the taxable income below the limit prescribed under the presumptive taxation and as income exceeding the threshold limit, and hence it will be applicable. Now, if we talk about the due dates, the due dates for the filing of this return for the current year. Let me take you through that. The due date for filing of tax audit report is for the current year is 31st October of the assessment year. That assessment year means for the previous year 2019-20. Correct. So the assessment year for previous year 2019-20 will be assessment year 2020-21. Correct. So during this year, 31st October is the deadline for filing of tax audit. Tax audit report, yes. Second is due date of written filing. If the audit is applicable, then it is 30th of November. If tax audit is not applicable, then also 30th November. Then if you are covered under section 92 to 92A, which is with regard to transfer pricing related to international transactions, in that case also 30th November. My dear friends, it seems so simple that because the deadlines are one or two only, but every year, this is due to the COVID pandemic that the deadlines has been extended. But if you see, for each and every category, the deadlines would be different depending on the circumstances. So this is very crucial. But for the current year, as we are focusing on for this tax audit season, I have considered the dates which are applicable for the current period. Now, the structure of tax audit, it is very important to understand that what is the structure of tax audit, because many of the clients, apart from that, I'm sorry to say, but many of the professionals also are not aware about the difference between the 3CA, 3CB and 3CD. So my urge is that if the professionals are not aware, how the assessee would be in a position to understand. So this kind of awareness is basically necessary so that a basic bottom line of knowing of compliances and tax is good on the part of assessee as well as the professionals. Yes, friends. So let's start with the structure of tax audit under section 44AB. Here there are two parts. Audit report is under form 3CA, 3CB. I have covered the basic 3CB. I have ignored right now because that is an exceptional case. Second, there is statement of particulars form 3CD. Jab bhi hum baat karte tax audit, to people are like, there is only one form. No, friends. There are two parts in the tax audit. One is the audit report. Mind well, as it is an audit, audit report has to be always there. So there is a audit report which is under 3CA or 3CB. We are covering only two part. And the statement of particulars is form 3CD. In normal terms, if you understand, जब हम regular audit करवाते हैं companies act या उसी और कोई act के अंदर, तो वहाँ पे independent auditor's report होता है. वो audit report होता है on the financial statement of the client. So whereby the professional or chartered accountant mentioned that we are giving this report on the basis of the financial statement that we have reviewed and conducted audit. So similar pattern. स्टेटमेंट ऑफ पर्टिकुलर. अब मैं जो लाइन बोलने वाला हूँ ये बहुत प्रोफेशनल्स को असेसिस को नहीं पता, बट ये जानना बहुत जरूरी है दैट स्टेटमेंट ऑफ पर्टिकुलर फॉर्म 3CD इज द प्रिपरेशन ऑफ द फॉर्म 3CD इज द लायबिलिटी ऑफ द असेसी एंड नॉट द प्रोफेशनल्स. माइंड वेल फ्रेंड्स, कंसिडर इट इन द फॉर्म ऑफ फाइनेंशियल स्टेटमेंट. फाइनेंशियल स्टेटमेंट बनाने की जिम्मेदारी किसकी है? क्लाइंट की, ना ही चार्टर्ड अकाउंटेंट की. In the similar fashion, statement of particulars form 3CD preparation is the liability of assessee या client या taxpayer. उसे review करके auditor report देता है under form 3CA और 3CB. This understanding is very necessary, friends. Statement of form 3CD क्या है? जैसे मैं financial statement बात करूँ तो हमें पता है balance sheet, P&L, cash flow, schedules, groups, notes, etc. तो form 3CD क्या है? हम उसे जानेंगे आगे की slides में. उससे पहले हम कवर करेंगे 3CA एंड 3CB ऑडिट रिपोर्ट. नाउ व्हेन आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट 3CA एंड 3CB, तो डिफरेंस क्या है 3CA और 3CB के बीच? सो फॉर बेसिक अंडरस्टैंडिंग आई कैन से दैट फॉर्म 3CA इज एप्लीकेबल टू ऑल दोज असेसी वेयर दैट असेसी इज कैरिंग आउट अ बिजनेस और अ प्रोफेशन व्हिच इज ऑलरेडी मैंडेटेड टू गेट अकाउंट्स ऑडिटेड अंडर एनी अदर लॉ. व्हेन आई एम सेइंग दैट एनी अदर लॉ, सो दैट मींस अपार्ट फ्रॉम इनकम टैक्स एक्ट. इनकम टैक्स एक्ट के अंदर जब आते हो तो आपको देखना है कंप्लायंस ऑफ सेक्शन 44AB और AD और एनी अदर रिलेवेंट सेक्शन. बट इधर आने से पहले, बिफोर कमिंग टू इनकम टैक्स, इफ योर बुक्स ऑफ अकाउंट्स आर ऑलरेडी ऑडिटेड अंडर एनी अदर एक्ट, देन प्लीज ऑडिटर इश्यू द रिपोर्ट अंडर फॉर्म 3CA. तो बचा क्या फॉर्म 3CB. तो वॉट डज इट सिंपली मीन कि जो असेसी ऐसा बिजनेस कैरी आउट करते हैं, प्रोफेशन कैरी आउट करते हैं, उनका कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन ऐसा है जहां पे उनके बुक्स ऑफ अकाउंट्स आर नॉट रिक्वायर्ड टू गेट ऑडिटेड अंडर एनी अदर लॉ, तो उन केसेस में आपको रिपोर्ट इश्यू करना है फॉर्म 3CB. सो बेसिक एग्जांपल फॉर 3CA में भी LLP 40 लाख का टर्नओवर क्रॉस हो गया, या तो फिर 25 लाख या 40 लाख का, जो भी है. और कंपनीज एक्ट अगर आप फॉलो होते हो फॉर पर्पज ऑफ कैरिंग आउट द ऑडिट, तो अगर आपका ऑडिट वहां पे हो चुका है रिस्पेक्टिव लॉ में, तो आपके ऑडिटर को आपको फॉर्म 3CA में रिपोर्ट इश्यू करना है अंडर इनकम टैक्स एक्ट. और अगर आप प्रोप्राइटर या पार्टनरशिप हो जिनका मैंडेटरी नहीं है अदर एक्ट में ऑडिट करवाना, तो आप फॉल हो गए अंडर फॉर्म 3CB और आपके ऑडिटर को 3CB ऑडिट रिपोर्ट इश्यू करना है. अब क्यों इतना हाईलाइट है? क्योंकि दोनों में डिटेल्स अलग अलग जाती है अंडर फॉर्म 3CA एंड 3CB. सो लेट अस अंडरस्टैंड फॉर्म 3CA एंड 3CB डिफरेंटली. पॉइंट वन, अंडर 3CA देयर इज अ बेसिक डिटेल्स, फॉर एग्जाम्पल नेम एंड एड्रेस अलॉन्ग विद द पेन ऑफ द टैक्स पेयर. ऑडिटर, मैं जो ऑडिट कर रहा हूँ, मैं प्रोफेशनल. लॉ अंडर विच द अकाउंट हैज बीन ऑडिटेड, से फॉर एग्जांपल यहाँ पे हम मेंशन करेंगे कि ऑलरेडी दिस बुक्स ऑफ अकाउंट, द बुक्स ऑफ अकाउंट्स ऑफ द बिजनेस कैरिड आउट बाय द असेस इज ऑलरेडी ऑडिटेड अंडर सो एंड सो एक्ट, बी इट GST, बी इट कंपनीज एक्ट, एनी अदर एक्ट. द डेट ऑफ ऑडिट रिपोर्ट इज मेंशन्ड. द पीरियड ऑफ प्रॉफिट एंड लॉस और एक्सपेंडिचर एंड इनकम इन केस ऑफ प्रोफेशनल इज टू बी मेंशन्ड. The date of balance sheet is also to be mentioned. Apart from that, there is a declaration which is attached to the declaration is being given that we are attaching form 3CD along with this audit report, so that on the basis of 3CD mapping can be done for the report. Then there is a section in the audit report to mention the audit observations or qualifications with regard to the form 3CD which has been filled and provided by the assessee to the chartered accountant. Point 4 is place and date of signing audit report. Name, address, membership number, the basic details. Okay. Now there is particulars on form 3CB. The more or less the details will be same apart from the audit angle which was covered under the other act. So here are the basic details: date of balance sheet, period of P&L, name and address of the taxpayer, similar fashion. The address where the books of accounts are kept, address of the branches. Audit observation, qualification, comments, etc. from the viewpoint of the auditor. Then there is a declaration by the auditor regarding obtaining information and explanation necessary for audit. assurance that the organization maintains proper books of accounts and the balance sheet gives true and fair review. So thereby, you have to understand that this is an audit, nothing but an audit report in the form of, in the form which has already been prescribed in the specified design by the Income Tax Act. Then there is point 4, declaration that we are attaching form 3CD along with this audit report, and observation or description with discrepancies with regard to form 3CD and the basic details of the auditor. Correct. Now, yes, very important for the viewpoint of the professionals as well as the business people that there is a form 3CD. Now, आपको अगर जानना हो फॉर्म 3CD क्या है, अगर आपको अंडरस्टैंडिंग रखनी हो तो आप ऐसे रख सकते हो, इंडिपेंडेंट ऑडिटर रिपोर्ट का अलग है, फाइनेंशियल स्टेटमेंट अलग है, फाइनेंशियल स्टेटमेंट के ऊपर ऑडिटर रिपोर्ट देता है, देन इट बिकम्स एन ऑडिटेड फाइनेंशियल स्टेटमेंट्स, करेक्ट. इन द सिमिलर फैशन फॉर्म 3CD इज देयर ऑन विच फॉर्म 3CA और 3CB इज अटैच एंड दैट बिकम्स एन टैक्स ऑडिट और रिपोर्ट, करेक्ट. सो फॉर्म 3CD इज अ स्टेटमेंट ऑफ पर्टिकुलर्स एज डिफाइंड बाय द एक्ट, करेक्ट. So, what are the details that has been mentioned in the Form 3CD? So, Form 3CD, may there are 41 different clauses, or you can, for your understanding, you can consider as questions. There are 41 questions for which you have to provide details point by point. And wherever there are certain formats which has been made available in the format, you have to provide the details in that specified format which has been provided by the income tax. So that contains various details. Starting from your PAN, your GST number, your business address, the year for which audit is conducted, section under which audit is conducted, whether there are changes in your partnership during the year. I'll be covering what are the important points. But कह सकते हैं कि वो आपका कच्चा चिट्ठा निकाल लेते हैं कि during the year आपका business structure क्या था, क्या क्या transactions जो income tax के angle से important है वो आपने cover किए हैं कि नहीं, correct. अब इसमें दो, एज आई मेंशन कि देर आर 41 डिफरेंट क्वेश्चंस, उसमें से दो क्वेश्चन ऐसे है क्लॉज 30 एंड 44 या 41 जो हम कह सकते हैं, उसे डिफर किया गया है ड्यू टू पेंडेमिक. मतलब देर आर टोटल 44 क्लॉजेस जिसमें वो ऊपर गलती से 41 लिखा है, 44 क्लॉजेस जिसमें 30C और 44 जो है दैट हैज बीन डिफर्ड स्पेसिफिकली टिल मार्च 2021, जहां पे रिपोर्टिंग है टार के अंदर, दैट इज टैक्स ऑडिट रिपोर्ट के अंदर, गार का विच रिगार्ड टू जनरल एंटी अवॉइडेंस रूल्स एंड अदर इज रिगार्ड टू GST विच हैज बीन डिफर्ड कंसीडरिंग द COVID-19 पेंडेमिक. नाउ जैसे मैं बता रहा था कि फॉर्म 3CD इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर्म, जहां पे इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट्स क्या ध्यान रखने हैं, तो यहां पे देयर इज अ कॉन्सेप्ट कॉल्ड ICDS. अगर आपने सुना हो अकाउंटिंग स्टैंडर्ड और Ind AS, वो बातें होती इन टर्म्स ऑफ अकाउंटिंग, पर जब आप लैंड करते हो इन टर्म्स ऑफ इनकम टैक्स, तो यहाँ पे उन्होंने न्यू कॉन्सेप्ट डेवलप किया है ICDS, विच स्टैंड्स फॉर इनकम कंप्यूटेशन एंड डिस्क्लोजर स्टैंडर्ड्स. तो यहाँ पे डिटेल्स होगी इन द सिमिलर फैशन विथ रिगार्ड टू अकाउंटिंग स्टैंडर्ड्स, जहाँ पे आप अराउंड 8 to 10 डिफरेंट ICDSs आर देयर विच प्रिस्क्राइब्स द मेथड टू बी फॉलोड फॉर द पर्पज ऑफ फिलिंग द डिटेल्स इन द 3CD, maintaining your records as per income tax and filing your ITR. So this becomes very crucial. Agar usme kuch RICO hai, non-compliance hai, toh ITR mein bhi mention hoga, mind well friends. Then there is important section with regard to reporting of section 40A3, which is with regard to cash payments. Then yahan pe aapko dhyan rakhna hai ki payment has not been made in excess of 10,000 rupees. Then there is another section with regard to section 269 SST SSU, whereby loan or advance has not been taken or given in exceeding 20,000 rupees. Or GST related details bhi provide karni hai, hame closing balance kya tha during the return ke jo details hai wo. Various compliances be it related to PF, ESIC, etc. Fixed assets ki details deni hai hame. रिपोर्टिंग जो करना है फिगर्स का, वो भी इन लाइन विद ऑडिटेड फाइनेंशियल स्टेटमेंट होना चाहिए. तो यस फ्रेंड्स, इट बिकम्स वेरी क्रूशियल कि ये सारे पॉइंट्स को बारीकी से देखा जाए. कंसीडरिंग द बेसिक अंडरस्टैंडिंग, आई हैव नॉट कवर्ड द क्लॉजेस, अदरवाइज इट वुड बी वेरी ब्यूटीफुल एंड अंडरस्टैंडिंग एंड नरेटिव इफ वी टेक क्लॉज बाय क्लॉज 44 क्लॉजेस को हम पॉइंट बाय पॉइंट अंडरस्टैंड करें कि इसमें क्या डिटेल डालनी है. तो इट बिकम्स वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर प्रोफेशनल एज वेल एज असेसी कि आपकी डिटेल्स प्रॉपर जाए इनकम टैक्स के पास. एंड लास्ट इज अटैचमेंट ऑफ नोट्स अपेंडेड टू 3CD, वेयर आई लर्न्ड एंड इनहेरिटेड फ्रॉम माय प्रोफेशनल एज दे सेड फ्रॉम द प्रीवियस फॉर्म, एंड दिस इज अ गुड हैबिट विच हैज बीन डेवलप्ड मैनी ऑफ द प्रोफेशनल्स क्या करते हैं कि 3CD रिपोर्ट भर दिया, 3CD फॉर्म भरा, उसके ऊपर रिपोर्ट दिया, एंड द डिटेल्स हैज बीन सेंट. बट अगर आप असेसी हो जो बिजनेस में थोड़ा बहुत ध्यान देते हो, या तो फिर आप प्रोफेशनल हो, देर आर सर्टेन पॉइंट्स लाइक नोट्स टू अकाउंट, जहां पे हम क्लैरिटी देते हैं कि ये चीज को हमने ऐसे किया है, इसमें ये कॉन्सेप्ट फॉलो हुआ, इसमें ये गाइडलाइंस हमने फॉलो की है. सो दिस हैबिट कैन बी डेवलप्ड अपार्ट फ्रॉम फॉर्म 3CD में. अब जब आगे बताऊंगा कि जब इसे सबमिट कैसे करना है, उस टाइम पे नोट्स अपेंडेड टू 3CD इज काइंड ऑफ अ नोट्स डॉक्यूमेंट. एक 2-3 पेज का डॉक्यूमेंट आप बना सकते हो सेक्शन बाय सेक्शन, जहां पे आपको डिटेल देनी है. क्योंकि होगा क्या कि फॉर्म 3CD एक फॉर्म स्ट्रक्चर है जो इनकम टैक्स ने दिया है, विथ सर्टेन रिस्ट्रिक्शंस इन फिलिंग दी डिटेल्स. तो अगर आपको डिस्क्रिप्टिव मैनर में कुछ मेंशन करना है, तो डेफिनेटली यू कैन ऐड ऑन अनदर पेज विच यू कैन गेट इट ऑडिटेड और रिव्यूड बाय योर CA एंड गेट इट साइंड, सो दैट इट कैन बी अटैच्ड अलॉन्ग विथ योर टैक्स ऑडिट रिपोर्ट. जहां पे आप मेंशन कर सकते हो कंप्लायंसेस ऑफ ICDS, या तो फिर डिटेल में कुछ लिखना हो विथ रिगार्ड टू अदर पॉइंट्स, फॉर एग्जांपल इन्वेंटरी, या तो फिर कंप्लायंस ऑफ ICDS में अगर रिकंसिलिएशन आपको दिखाना है, या एनी अदर पॉइंट. तो दिस कैन बी यूज्ड इन अटैचमेंट फॉर्म. अब जब आपकी बात आती है, हमने आगे देखा कि अगर आप प्रिजम्प्टिव टैक्सेशन में जाते हो तो आपको बुक्स ऑफ अकाउंट्स मेंटेन नहीं करनी, बट बाकी जिन लोगों को बुक्स ऑफ अकाउंट्स मेंटेन करनी है, दैट इज बीन रिफाइंड अंडर रूल 6F. तो वहां पे मेंशन किया है कि आपको कैश बुक, जर्नल, लेजर्स, बिल्स और रिसीट्स, ओरिजिनल बिल्स मेंटेन करना है. यू आर इनटू योर मेडिकल प्रोफेशन अगर है तो एडिशनल रिकॉर्ड्स भी बहुत सारे मेंटेन करने हैं आपको. तो डेली केस रजिस्टर्स विद डिटेल्स ऑफ पेशेंट, फीस रिसीव्ड, एक्सेट्रा, स्टॉक डिटेल्स ऑफ मेडिसिन, कंज्यूमेबल्स, एक्सेट्रा. तो रूल 6F अगर हम पढ़े तो उसमें मेंशन किया है कैटेगरी कि अगर आपको गवर्नमेंट ने बोला है, टैक्स इनकम टैक्स एक्ट ने कहा है कि आपको बुक्स ऑफ अकाउंट्स मेंटेन करनी है, तो ये स्टेटमेंट ऑफ 3CD में भी लिखा है कि वेदर द बुक्स एज मेंशन्ड अंडर द एक्ट हैज बीन प्रॉपरली मेंटेन्ड बाय द असेसी और नॉट, उसमें यस नो भी लिखना है. तो इट बिकम्स वेरी क्रूशियल ऑन द पार्ट ऑफ असेसी एंड ऑन द पार्ट ऑफ प्रोफेशनल टू वेरीफाई वेदर द बुक्स ऑफ अकाउंट्स हैज बीन मेंटेन्ड प्रॉपरली और नॉट. नाउ प्रोसीजर ऑफ सबमिशन. तो प्रोसीजर ऑफ सबमिशन में ऐसा है कि एज इट इज एन डिजिटल प्लेटफॉर्म, यहाँ पे आपको फॉर्म भी XML में बनेगा, 3CD जो आपका होगा दैट विल ऑल्सो बी फिल्ड इन 3XML फॉर्म. तो सबसे पहले प्रोसीजर क्या रहेगी, द टैक्स ऑडिटर शैल फर्निश टैक्स ऑडिट रिपोर्ट ऑनलाइन बाय यूजिंग लॉगिन इन द कैपेसिटी ऑफ चार्टर्ड अकाउंटेंट. मतलब ऐसा नहीं, फॉर एग्जाम्पल मैं वेदांत परीख, मेरा एक पैन है अलोकेटेड, मैं उसमें जाके आपका रिटर्न भर सकता हूँ, नहीं. मुझे मेरी एक आईडी अलग बनानी है जिसका प्रीफिक्स होगा आर का, ARCA, पीछे आपका मेंबरशिप नंबर होगा 6 डिजिट का, उसमें लॉगिन आईडी क्रेडेंशियल्स बनेंगे और उसमें से आपको आपका रिटर्न, क्लाइंट का रिटर्न अपलोड करना है. अब वो करने से पहले आपको क्लाइंट के पोर्टल में जाके CA को ऐड करना होगा. मतलब मैं ABC लिमिटेड हूँ, मैंने विद परीख एंड एसोसिएट्स मेरी जो फर्म है उसे अपॉइंट किया फॉर टू कैरी आउट द टैक्स ऑडिट. तो पहले ABC कंपनी लिमिटेड में मुझे जाके ई फाइलिंग पोर्टल में जाके लॉगिन करके ऐड CA करना होगा परीख एंड एसोसिएट्स, उसमें भी कौन से पार्टनर, तो से फॉर एग्जांपल वेदांत परीख, वो साइन करेंगे मेरा टैक्स ऑडिट रिपोर्ट. ये डिटेल मैंने ऐड की, देन एंड ओनली देन मैं वेदांत परीख, पार्टनर ऑफ परीख एंड एसोसिएट्स, कैन फाइल दी टैक्स ऑडिट रिपोर्ट ऑफ ABC लिमिटेड. So once the tax auditor uploads the audit report, same should either be accepted or rejected by the taxpayer in their login portal. तो चलो मैं रीड करने की जगह पे आपको समझाता हूँ. सबसे पहले मैं असेसी हूँ, मैंने मुझे ऐड करना है CA को अपने अंदर, ऐड CA किया मैंने विथ माई डिटेल्स. वंस माई डिटेल्स हैज बीन एडेड इन टू द पोर्टल, उसके बाद क्या होगा कि मैं एज एन ऑडिटर मेरा लॉग इन डालूंगा, उसके अंदर मैं क्या करूँगा, मैं मेरी बैलेंस शीट अटैच करनी है मुझे क्लाइंट की, PNL अटैच करना है क्लाइंट का, नोट्स अटैच करनी है फाइनेंशियल स्टेटमेंट की उसके अंदर. अपार्ट फ्रॉम दैट मुझे नोट्स अपेंडेड टू 3CD अगर आपने बनाई है फॉर क्लेरिफिकेशन, तो वो भी आप अदर में जाके ऐड कर सकते हो. उसके अलावा क्या ऐड करोगे आप, तो XML फाइल ऑफ टैक्स ऑडिट रिपोर्ट आप उसमें अटैच करोगे और आपकी डिजिटल सिग्नेचर अटैच करनी है आपको उसके अंदर. ये हो जाए तो आप सबमिट करोगे तो वो अपलोड हो जाएगा अब आपके पोर्टल में से क्लाइंट के पोर्टल में. तो वो यहाँ से निकला और पहुंचेगा क्लाइंट के पोर्टल में. क्लाइंट को रिव्यू अगर करना है कि मेरे CA ने प्रॉपर डिटेल्स फिल की है कि नहीं, सी हियर इट इज अ कंट्रोल पॉइंट. जैसे मैं पहले बता रहा था कि यू शुड बी अवेयर, तो यहाँ पे जाके आपको पूछा जाएगा कि भाई आपके CA ने आपका रिटर्न और टैक्स ऑडिट रिपोर्ट फाइल किया है, आपको एक्सेप्ट करना है या रिजेक्ट करना है. तो आपको अगर प्रॉपर लगे तो एक्सेप्ट करिए, कोई प्रॉब्लम लगे तो रिजेक्ट करिए. करेक्ट. यू मस्ट फाइल द टैक्स ऑडिट रिपोर्ट ऑन और बिफोर द ड्यू डेट ऑफ फाइलिंग द रिटर्न ऑफ इनकम. दैट इज बेसिक बॉटम लाइन. पेनल्टी फॉर नॉन फाइलिंग, एज मैंने बताया कि इंडिया में या कहीं पे भी अक्रॉस द ग्लोब अगर आपको लॉ इम्प्लीमेंट किए गए हैं तो उसके स्ट्रिक्टर कंप्लायंसेस के लिए पेनल्टी भी डाली गई है. तो इन द सिमिलर फैशन यहाँ पे क्या कहा गया है, इफ एनी टैक्स पेयर हु इज रिक्वायर्ड टू गेट द टैक्स ऑडिट डन बट फेल्स टू डू सो देन एट लीस्ट ऑफ द फॉलोइंग मे बी लिविड एज पेनल्टी. So there are two conditions. One is 0.5%, 0.5% of the total sales turnover or gross receipts will be the fee, will be the penalty, or 1,50,000, whichever is minimum. So 1.5 lakh to seedha chuna lagna hi hai agar aapne tax audit nahi karwaya to. So dear friends, it is my urge, appoint a proper and knowledgeable professional who can guide you in a proper manner for the conduct of tax audit. Otherwise आप जितना टैक्स भरोगे या प्रोफेशनल को जितनी फीस दोगे उससे ज्यादा आपको पेनल्टी लगने वाली है. सो बी अवेयर अबाउट दैट थिंग. करेक्ट. सो थैंक यू सो मच. दिस वाज ऑल अबाउट द ब्रीफ अबाउट द टैक्स ऑडिट व्हिच इज मेंशन अंडर द इनकम टैक्स एक्ट. एंड माई रिग्रेट्स दैट कंसिडरिंग द नेचर ऑफ टाइम एंड द लिमिटेड डेज एंड द टाइम फ्रेम व्हिच हैज बीन मेड अवेलेबल, आई एम एबल टू कवर ओनली द बेसिक्स. In the near future, if we get a time, we'll be discussing about the 41 clauses in detail, which will help you for the thorough understanding of the tax audit clause. Yes, Vishalji, I think it's done on my side.
Thank you, Vidhanji. Now I request Karan Nayan to take over.
Yes, sir. My evening friends, this is Karan Naik here. Today we are going to talk about now, next topic is going to be Veer Agro. Before we take on the questions, so tab tak Vedanji will have to take a small break and we'll come back
sir,
to you after this.
Karanji sir, that's what my request was. Please. I am running short of time, I have some other commitment as well. So if you can allow me to share my screen, I'll be sharing my contact details.